If you don't have an Oculus Quest, you definitely should consider picking up the Anker new docking station for the Quest 2. What's going on, everyone? So yeah, in this video, I'm gonna go ahead and share with you my 1 week experience with this accessory and share with you my thoughts and things that I learned after owning it. And full disclosure, I bought this out of my out-of-pocket money because this was something I was definitely looking forward to, because this is a lot better than just leaving your VR headset somewhere in a room. This docking station allows you to not just organize the Quest, but also make sure it stays in place securely so nobody steps on it or damages your headset. So this retails for just under $100, uneven asking price, as it starts at $86.99. Unboxing this, it actually feels extremely premium, almost on par to Apple's quality, as everything is nicely laid out. You have the dock station right here that actually is pretty hefty. It connects with a USB-C to USB-C port on the back. A USB-C fast charger is included. The battery covers, simply just replace the current ones on your Oculus Quest. And since this is partnered with Oculus, the color contrast is a 1-to-1. So it matches the controller colors extremely well. Unfortunately, it's not grippy. I originally thought it was gonna have some type of grip texture, but it's fine. It does have a magnetic USB adapter right here, which connects on the side of the Oculus Quest headset. This is how it connects to the dock station. So it's kind of like what Apple does with its MagSafe technology. And then it comes with rechargeable AA batteries. Installing everything is as easy as just installing regular batteries by just swapping the battery cover on the Quest 2 controllers, like so. Make sure the terminals are facing upwards so it could pass through the battery cover. And that's basically it. And yes, it does work with the Elite controller. So the key things to highlight about this docking station, it's extremely convenient just dropping everything in. And from a 0% battery charge on the VR headset, it will take roughly an hour, 2.5 hours to charge everything, which isn't really bad. It is certified by Oculus. Of course, their engineers went ahead and looked at it and made sure it was fully optimized. And it has nice safety features, as the grip right here where the Oculus Quest headset, this texture is nice and soft and grippy, so it won't be able to damage the VR headset from marks or scratches in the future. Same applies for the Quest 2 touch controllers. You just dock them in place, just like so. Now, the only con I see about this thing is, since it connects with a magnetic port right here, which switches the USB port with a magnetic one, there's no way you could transfer data from the VR headset to your computer. So if you're trying to export a video clip or images, or maybe you also use sideload on your Quest headset, you're gonna have to take this out to plug in a standard data transfer USB-C port. And if you're somebody that uses your PC a lot to play Oculus Link, this is non-compatible. But if you're somebody like me who also uses virtual desktop, this shouldn't be an issue, as you can just do that all wirelessly with your Wi-Fi connection. Now, if you're concerned if the dock is easy to move around whenever you dock the VR headset, it isn't. The bottom, not only is it super grippy, but the dock itself. In fact, when I was doing the move test to see how easy it'll slide around, it was moving my entire desk. And the way this docking station works is, the part that connects to the VR headset does move freely, so it's always able to get a nice connection, but every once in a while you are required to move it a bit more to actually hear that satisfying click. But from a far distance, this docking station looks extremely presentable. I mean, it blends in really well if you have like a gaming console setup where your consoles are right next to it. This blends in so well that it just becomes one with the VR headset. So it has that low-key look, which I definitely do like, instead of having cables dinging around connected to the VR headset if you just leave it on the stand charging, as I recently had it before. Although the only con I'm not a huge fan of is the wrist straps. They just randomly dangle down like that. They just randomly just flop right in front of it, so it can look kind of odd unless you remove the straps entirely, which isn't really recommended. Heck, I just noticed their advertisement, they show it without the straps, and no, there's no groove or anything inside it where you could tuck it away. Then another con I see about this thing, another one of my complaints, is the included charging adapter. This thing is absolutely bulky. If you use one of these surge protectors, you're gonna have to probably swap it with a smaller one if you have one, or you're gonna have to sacrifice two outlets just to make this thing fit. But other than that, when you have everything connected, I really do like the LED indicators. They switch from an amber color, which means it's charging, and they become solid green once the VR headset is fully charged. And if you're concerned if this is safe for the VR headset to constantly leave it full, it's a yes and no. You see, the thing about batteries, all batteries are like this, cell phones, laptop, even Tesla batteries, I know this from shopping in a market for a Tesla, is batteries work by cycles. A complete cycle, if you let the battery go from 0% and charge it back up to 100, that is one cycle. If you charge the headset between 20 to 30% back to 100, you should be fine. But if you leave it in full max at 100 without using it for a long period of time, that could hurt the longevity of the battery, but nowhere near as damaging if you leave the VR headset go all the way to zero. And plus, you gotta take in consideration, Anker teamed up with Oculus, so this partnership was engineered and focused to make sure this docking station is 100% optimized and safe for the Quest headset. And also, it's Anker, the company that has been making accessories for years now to perfect charging for premium phones like iPhones and Androids, Samsungs and all that good stuff. So this is a company I'll definitely trust to charge my devices from past personal experience. Other than that, that is the docking station in a nutshell. Do I recommend? Yes. Is it a great value? Of course it is. Since it's right below $100, it's a good buy. Plus, it really does organize your setup. There you guys have it. That is my honest review, my in-depth review of this new docking station for the Oculus Quest 2. If you found this video extremely informative, don't just simply hit that like button, but also get subscribed and make sure to use that link in the video description down below, as that is an affiliate link and it does help out the channel because this is a non-sponsored video. But by clicking on that link, supports the channel and allows me to continue informing you guys on some of these accessories before you go buy. And for more Oculus Quest stuff, if you're new to the Quest VR headset, make sure to check out this video over here as I go through my favorite tips and tricks and some hidden features that you could do on the Quest 2. And then that video over there, that's just a video that YouTube is recommending specifically for you. Thanks so much for watching. Take care, and I'll catch you all in the next one. See ya.